So from here, from this analysis, what we can conclude is that first point is, what is the first point? At the modulated output, where are you taking the output? At the collector. The carrier is, what will happen, because it is IC1 difference IC2, if they are same, if they are of same type of transistors, IC1 is equal to IC2, therefore IC1 minus IC2 or IC2 minus IC1, either way, will be just zero. If they are manufactured from the same batch, same characteristics, same parameters, then IC will be zero. So that means when IC is zero, what do you have? You have only sidebands. What are the sidebands that you are talking about? That is that omega C plus omega M, the sum component, and omega C minus omega M, the difference component. So we say that, what is it that we can conclude from this is that the carrier is suppressed. So because of this circuit here, the carrier is suppressed. Okay. When the carrier is suppressed, then we want say half power points, these are carrier power, sideband power. If carrier is reduced, the power is only half coming from the sidebands. So there is, what does it mean? The power is same, because it is contributing to half the maximum power. If it is one sideband, it is half the power. Two side, it is PT by PC is 1 plus MA squared by 2, isn't it? So if MA is 100%, then it is only 1/5 of the power that you are getting. So it is known as carrier is suppressed, the power is saved. So in most of the applications, it is advantageous to use balanced modulators. In some applications, you may have to eliminate modulating circuits. In such a case, what should you do? Interchange. If you interchange modulating signal with the carrier, then modulating signal will be eliminated. So this is how you will be producing what is known as a modulating signal. AM modulated wave. Having produced modulated, where the next task is to be able to recover the signal back. To recover a signal back, what we use is a demodulator circuit. This demodulator circuit is also known as a detector circuit. So it is very simple. Here you have, at this, you have modulating signal, and XC is 1 by 2 pi FC. So higher frequencies are allowed, lower frequencies only will be positive. Then you use a diode, then you get either positive peaks or negative. If it is positive, you get this resistor, and what you get is a pure circuit. So just copy down this circuit, we will discuss it in the next class. Those who finished copying, you can leave now.